welcome you all to this series of session on the concept of network security. So I would like to ask you a question before this discussion. Do you know how we are interacting right now? Of course, with the help of internet. And if we split this word internet, what we get is two terms, inter, and the other term is net. This term net is an abbreviation of the word network. So if we define network, it is nothing but a group of connections of two or more than two computers. The important aim or goal of creating a network is to have a smooth sharing of resources, for example, data or file. The computers that are connected in a network are called the work computers. Now, the person who is working on a work computer is called a user. These work computers will connect and form a network, and through that, the data or information can be shared from one work computer to other work computer. Now, as we discuss the basic need of a network, network is used to share the data, and these data can be sometimes very confidential. We have seen that many times if we receive any courier, then sometimes it is secured and sealed as confidential, which means only the intended receiver should access it. Same way, if we do not secure our network, then the data that is being shared among the work computers will not remain secure. And instead of intended receiver, every person on the network or outside of the network will access the data. And it should not actually happen, right? So, network security is involved in many organizations, enterprises, and many other private and public institutions. In a network, it is not necessary that all the participants are legitimate or valid users. So, to avoid these types of conflicts, we have to have the concept of security basics. Security basics will be discussed in the upcoming videos. But securing the network not only means securing it in terms of software components, but also in terms of hardware components. Basically, securing anything refers to 10% of mechanisms used for security and 90% of human effort. Why this? Because the human effort is the first thing that comes in the picture. If we take an example, if we want to secure the house, then the human effort is required at first to lock the door, right? After locking the door, keeping the key securely is also a mandatory task. Same way, to secure our softwares in the computer, we need to have the security softwares like QuickHeal and Kaspersky. In these topics, the most important part is the understanding of the terminologies. In these subjects, we will have a lot of terminologies and its definitions. I will introduce to the basic topics of security, that is threat and attack. Generally, we use these words in daily life, but we don't actually know the meaning and difference between these two terms, right? So, if I define threat, then threat can be defined as threat can be a person or anything that is likely to cause damage or danger to our work computer or the user. And if we define attack, an attack is an attempt to alter, destroy, steal, or gain the unauthorized access and make the unauthorized use of a work computer or a user in the network. So this was the basic definition of threat and attack. And in our upcoming series, the topics that we will be discussing will focus on securing the networks against the attacks that may cause harm to the work computers and also the benefits of having network security and computer security. Before ending this session, I have mentioned the list of questions that are possible to be asked in your examinations. So the first question is, what is a work computer? Then what is the meaning of internet? Third one, define threat, then define attacks, and lastly, define the network. You can write the answers in the comment box and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.